Okay, this is the aftermath of this is January 24th today. It's a Monday. Anyway, I'm not gonna go into a lot of detail, but tornado took that chair because it started spinning around. I thought, oh, it's a tornado, and it turned it facing that way. It knocked that chair over. It knocked all these branches off over here. This keeps switching too, and it shuts off because it's a piece of shit Sony. That fell off this tree right here. This large one here was over there, over here, but the wind blew it up against. We had the swimming pool covering our lawnmower. We had two lawnmowers and a tiller. We were covering them to keep the weather off it and all that because the tornado on December 31st took this off. See, like I said, if you see, I don't know if you can see it right there. There's one right there. There are screws here. The shed was screwed down to this platform, but it lifted it up, took it about 14, 15 feet north and 35 feet east into that tree and wrapped it, which is in a video from December 31st. We had a big, I had a big branch over here on this tomato plant here. I took that off, moved over there. I got them spread out now because I put them up on the front yard. I couldn't carry them all by myself. This one, this big tree right here, this branch right here was on our propane tank. There was another fairly good size. Well, not real big, but it was, you know, you see that one up there. And then that one right there, I'll show you around front. But the main reason I got it is because I got a zucchini on my back porch. I just measured it with a tape measure, 12 inches. Look at this, everything out here is standing okay. There was a branch that was knocked in over here by the spaghetti squash. Yeah, see, it looks like a small watermelon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 out here right now. There's a couple watermelons. That's residual. We didn't plant those. Those are from last year. They just came up. Purple hull peas right here. Right there and there. Right back there. Oh yeah, we had two zucchinis here. This is where I got the 12-inch zucchini on the back porch. I cut it off when I was out here. And I looked for the other zucchini, which was right here. You know where it is? Right there. The wind actually tore it up completely. That zucchini right there was about the same size almost, just a little bit smaller than that one right there. Right there where that hole is. And the winds did this. This is a round zucchini plant. Got a zucchini on there about the size of a 10-inch softball. I haven't seen anything else. I just saw this. I just saw that plant. That's why I went and got this camera so I could record it to show you. It's June 24th, Monday, 2019. And it's about 4:30 p.m. There's my other branches. Yeah, knocked over that sunflower right there, by the way. I got it with a green, one of those metal-coated tomato steaks. I got it propped up and it's gonna fall over again, so I am done with all this stuff. That's what happens with the winds out here. You want to know what the winds of hell are like? Come out here in the open. These are the other branches I pulled up here. I put the brace on my leg just to keep my leg because I don't want to be falling down the hill when no one's out here. This other big one here, that big one, that real big one out back. These are the ones I pulled off of that over here. Oh crap. See these branches right here. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, about 4 or 5 right here. And there's a couple of smaller ones right there. And there's a real big one that came off this tree. That was about halfway onto the road. And then the rain yesterday, I was out here trying to get by myself, trying to get down there. And I got it so far. I pulled it finally by the stub there. Pulling it. What I was doing was breaking off the branches at the end and throwing them over into the ditch because they were sticking out, like I said, midway into the road. And no help out here, just by myself trying to do it. So I broke off the branches the best I could, and they were still on the road this morning. And I just did everything I could to do, you know, and I pulled it kind of sideways so that it's on the edge of the road. The top of my, Jesus Christ, man. My compost bin that's right there. I had that 5 gallon bucket of paint, old paint in there. It was about half full. It's dried out, it's old, but it was on top of that. Blew that all off. It's down there in the ditch. It's directly across from that, down in that ditch over there. That's about 9-10 feet deep, but it's got all kinds of weeds and stuff, and I can't climb down there. There's no way I can get down there. But yeah, the winds out here are unbelievably treacherous. As a matter of fact, oh, I didn't rip that off, okay. Posted no hunting, no trespassing sign over here. But I'm surprised the wind didn't take this thing off. It was soaking wet. But yeah, see, here's the branches down here in the front yard. As far as I wasn't gonna go on down and end up breaking my neck or falling or anything while no one's out here. My mother-in-law passed away this morning in Ohio. And my wife's there with the family, so I'm here, and I didn't want to do anything and get hurt because there's no one here, you know. So anyway, that's how bad it is out here. Really, there it is. I think that's where it might broke off. I'm not gonna zoom in because the camera probably shut off. It is a Sony after all. Right there, I think. Looks like that's where that branch broke off. It's heavy, it's very heavy. So this is the aftermath of June 21st, 22nd, and 23rd, winds and some rain. It's like, I mean, gusts of wind. I thought for sure this was a tornado. Like I said, when I looked out the window on a previous video, I saw that chair actually turning, like it's getting ready to spin, and it just set, turned and set like that. And then that one got knocked over, and then I saw this big branch just drop right here on top of that propane tank with these others, and I slowly got them apart. And oh goodness, so yeah. And then my solar panel, nothing, stayed perfectly still right there. And then you see stuff like this here. Oh goodness. Yeah, knocked over the bird feeder over there. With the ring is somewhere down in the ground. I have to look for it later, tomorrow or next day. Somewhere down here is a solid ring, not a cheap thin wire. It's a good solid ring, but it was knocked over by this branch, so it should be down here somewhere. But again, living out in the open like this, and that's what's going to happen every time. I mean, I got at least, like I say, half a mile to a mile on all four sides of this house open. I mean, stuff like that, that's not enough to block anything. That's, you know, it's like a little fence. So winds out here don't even have to be storms. If there's like 15 to 20 mile an hour, that's enough to do some damage. But again, this is all the mess I got out here. And tomorrow, when I'm feeling better, before my knee starts hurting more, if I can get help, I'm gonna have to try to start getting these stuff like this I can get myself and throw them over in the ditch, but like this big heavy one here and those over there and out front, you're gonna have to get two people at least to get them. Oh gosh. Oh, yep, so that's the winds of hell, Gadsden, Tennessee. Yeah, that one there, last night when it was raining, not last night, like yesterday, early evening before it started getting dark, I pulled that to the side over there, and I moved the car up close to the house. But, oh goodness, man. I'm telling you, this is just rough. Look at this. This porch looks like, well, I'm not going to say what it looks like, but it's a mess. This is the squash that I picked off. I'm going to get this measuring tape back out here. This is, I did the recording and then it shut off because, again, it's a Sony. Oh crap. It's right there. 13, so it's 12 inches. But look at this stuff out here, man. I mean, I would be embarrassed if it was something I did, but this is just how we have to be because of how this place is out here. No room for anything. Every time we had a decent shed, it wasn't the best expensive one, but it was a cheap shed, but it was a shed. It was screwed down. You can, like I said, you can see the screws sticking up about every 2 feet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the end here. And then they go down the long ends. And it picked it up. You see how far back it was set from the house? Right here was the edge closest to the house. Okay, there's the house. There. So about 4 feet of it's overhung over there. And so 6 feet of it was on this side of the edge of the house. And it lifted this thing up off of the platform, took it over that way, and then 35 feet east into that tree. So, all right, that's it. I just wanted, this is a long video now, it's 10 minutes. So that's the aftermath of these damn storms out here.